people are now listening to what he has to say. The other Republican candidates can only pretend that they are what he's always stood for. Witness the power of an idea.
New Ron Paul campaign videos show his events overflowing, but those numbers haven't translated into a single win in any state so far. At a Texas A&M event on Tuesday, Paul was asked why.
I'm not really sure. And there's a lot of theories on this, but it looks like we don't get enough people to the polls.
Joining us now is Ron Paul campaign chairman Jesse Benton. Jesse, great to have you.
Thank you. Great to be here, Alex.
Jesse, where is the disconnect here? We anecdotally have stories about incredible enthusiasm and real allegiance to Ron Paul and his message, and yet no wins.
Well, I would again like to point out our 8 strong second places, including our second place finish in New Hampshire, where we beat the field in Governor Romney's own home state. But, you know, we need to continue to do better. We need to motivate our people, get them to the polls. And, you know, the people that were backing Senator Santorum were backing him because they were duped into thinking he was a real limited government person. Now, there's only one limited government person mm-hmm. left in the race. That's mm-hmm. Ron Paul. And so we welcome people that were, you know, backing Governor Santorum to come to us, both in the delegate process where we're going through the conventions and also in the upcoming primary contests.
Jesse, Ben Smith here. I wonder what sort of a role you'd like to see Rand Paul particularly playing at the convention, playing through the fall campaign, if you guys are talking to the Romney people about that at all.
No, we haven't talked about that, but, you know, I'd like to see Rand play a big role in our campaign as he has and in all future efforts going forward. I mean, Rand's a superstar. I was very humbled to be his campaign manager in his Senate campaign, and he's my friend, and he's a great spokesman for limited government, great spokesman for the Republican Party, and a great spokesman to independents as well.
Steve Kornacki has a question for you, Jesse.
Hey, Steve.
Yeah, hey, Jesse. Wanted to ask you about the convention, actually, then. So, you know, you're going to go there with, you know, maybe 100 delegates or something. What is it that you guys want to get out of the convention this summer? What is it that you can get? Because it occurs to me that when you look at this platform, the issues that matter most to your candidate seem to be absolutely opposed by everybody else, you know, who's run for president this year. So you're going to have 2,000 delegates on one side and 100 on your side. What is it that you think you can get at this convention, sort of in concrete terms?
Well, we're going to have a lot more than 100 bound delegates. And I'd also like to point out that, you know, Governor Romney really only has about 550 delegates, so he's only halfway. There's a lot more to be played out here. We're going to be competing very hard. For example, last night in Colorado's 7th Congressional District, we actually won one of the 3 delegates that were up for grabs in a district we did not expect to do well in. So the exit of Senator Santorum means that we're going to be picking up a lot more delegates, and we've always been poised to really exceed the delegate total that the media has been painting. But, you know, we're going to the convention to try to make Ron the nominee. As far as issues that I think the Republican Party and the independents that it needs to produce a winning coalition in the fall for a Republican ticket, I think transparency at the Federal Reserve, sound money, and a real audit of the Federal Reserve is something that people from across the ideological spectrum can get behind the Republican nominee and back, no matter who that happens to be.
Jesse, when we talk about the road ahead, I offer sometimes among close circles of associates, which this counts as, a theory that I have as far as the Republican Party. And I do think there is going to be some time spent on the psychologist couch at the end of this year as far as the party deciding what direction it's going to go in. In a lot of ways, I think Ron Paul has laid the seeds for a new sort of a GOP 2.0. And I think that, you know, I will quote, as I often do, the great Chris Saliza, who says, Paul is in a much stronger bargaining position than Gingrich to extract promises from Romney because he can do far more damage if he isn't placated. That's why, though both men have zero chance of being their party's standard bearer, Paul matters more than Gingrich. Worth noting that 24 active Paul backers are running for House or Senate seats. 200 are seeking local offices. There, I think, could be a Ron Paul movement that extends well beyond Ron Paul's candidacy.
Well, Ron Paul is the only candidate who actually is a movement candidate in this primary, and he's the only one who has been, and he appeals to younger voters in a very strong way. This is a problem that the Romney campaign wants to address. This is something they're going to have to address in the fall. So, I mean, I agree with Chris, and I, with all due respect to Jesse, who I like very much, I don't think that Ron Paul is going to remain a factor in terms of delegates. I think this race is going to continue to be sort of close to over. I don't think the Santorum vote is going to move to Ron Paul. But I do think Ron Paul has enough of his own supporters that he will continue to be something of a force and someone they have to deal with.
It's the damage that he can do ultimately through a kind of bully pulpit that probably has the Republicans nervous. Because I think that the more he stays on that libertarian edge and he's able to attract some independents, they like some of the stuff he says, oh, yeah, you know, in terms of foreign policy, that sounds good. But then it sounds like it's teetering toward, with all due respect to Mr. Benton, some of the lunatic fringe on other issues. So I want to ask Mr. Benton, do you think that Ron Paul sticks around so that he can leverage beyond this race? I mean, apropos to what Alex just said, maybe it's he's looking forward to after this Republican, you know, primary is done and the election is over, that he's trying to leverage it for future authority. Anything to that?
Well, he's sticking around first and foremost because this race is not over. We're still fighting hard in this race right now. And we're fighting to win. But, you know, a secondary goal of all of our political action that we've always undertaken for the past 5 years has been with a long-term goal and a long-term focus. Yeah, you know, we want to interject these ideas both into the Republican Party and to the American people at large. And we want to bring this country back to its founding roots of individual freedom, respect for the Constitution that made us so great.
Jesse, I will let you know that there is a copy of the Ron Paul cookbook in the now offices. Not purchased by anybody that works in this building, but we do have a copy. We read it religiously and are often inspired by many of the recipes. Thank you for your time, sir. We look forward to talking with you as the campaign progresses.
Thanks for having me.